Jaws dropped and there were audible gasps Thursday night at Sotheby's auction house in New York City when an overseas buyer, let's show him to you, this man on your screen, Japanese buyer and 41-year-old tech tycoon Yasuko Maezawa, made waves in the art world, and I'm talking gigantic waves. He was the buyer of this Jean-Michel Basquiat painting at a Sotheby's art auction for a record-breaking $110 million. That, folks, is the highest price ever paid for a work done by an American artist. Now, they say a good indication of how the economy is doing is whether the wealthy are investing in art. And in 2016, auction and private sales fell about 11%. But are they back now? And if so, why? Sotheby's CEO Tad Smith joins us. It's his first interview since that massive auction. Okay, I want to hear about moment. I want to hear about the moment that that painting was being auctioned, and there were two bidders by the end, correct?
I mean,
describe the scene.
First of all, you could hear a pin drop. And we have a marvelous auctioneer named Ollie Barker, and he just held the room in perfect suspense in his hands, and we were simply waiting to know whether there was going to be the next bid. And then there was. And then another wait, and then it stopped, and everyone knew the hammer came down and history was made.
I heard when it got up above 80 million, you started to hear gasps.
Well, interestingly, the first gasp was when he started the auction bidding at 57 million, which is the world record for Basquiat up to last Thursday. So that was the first gasp. And then there were multiple gasps between 80 and 90.
Not everybody's taste. The skull with acrylic paint and some spray paint. But Jean-Michel Basquiat, who died at age 27, half Haitian, half Puerto Rican, an American artist, is very, very hot right now. Let's show let's show the second highest painting that sold, and that was a Roy Lichtenstein, am I correct?
Yes, it was a beautiful Lichtenstein, sold for $24 million, and it was an incredible work.
What does this say about the economy? And I'm not saying the American economy, because we had a Japanese buyer for the top one, the Basquiat. Who's got the more money in which countries?
The truth is, Liz, it's everywhere around the world. If you just look at the world billionaires and you thought, I only want to allocate 5% of my net worth to buy the Basquiat, and you just use that as a threshold, there are 938 people on the list of Forbes world billionaires that could afford to buy the Basquiat. There are 320 using that measure just in the United States.
Well, these are the job creators. I know Ken Griffin, who of course is the Chicago hedge fund manager, had bought a de Kooning for millions of dollars. This guy does create jobs. How do you see that playing out when you get art buyers who are calling in?
There's no doubt that the world is full of entrepreneurs that are creating immense amounts of wealth, creating huge numbers of jobs, and frankly, there's an enormous amount of capital being built up. That's why you see philanthropy growing rapidly. That's why you see art growing rapidly. I mean, today, it's not so much that the pictures are so expensive. It's just relative to the wealth being created, they're less expensive.
Donald Trump, he has yet to pass a tax reform or a budget, and yet, psychologically, there seems to be a lift. Do you feel that?
There are definitely animal spirits that kicked off since the last election. There's no question about it. But the truth is, the administration needs to get some of those promises done if we're going to sustain it.
Okay.
That said, I will say, both in Europe, Asia, and the United States, it's a good growth outlook, so we feel pretty good about it.
Great to see you, Tad.
Really great to be here.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The whole sale reaped more than $300 million.
Yeah, $320 for the night and $816 for the week.
And the earrings, sorry, can we show the earrings really quickly? You had a huge...
$57 million for earrings, Apollo and Artemis, one blue, one pink.
What happened? A blue and a pink. It's an absolute stunner.
If we'd thought about it, we'd put them on you for the show.
Well, why didn't you think about it?
Next time.
Next time. Good to see you.
Thank you, Liz. Really great to be here.